Hello, this is Pastor Jim Bauer. Thank you for joining us on the Sunday morning message about the power in the blood of the Lamb. I grew up singing that song as a young boy. There's wonder-working power in the blood of the Lamb. Even our natural blood has some amazing properties in it. The white blood cells, the antibodies that fight disease and help give us protection in this life. But the blood of the Lamb of God is something awesome and special. And I'm going to talk to you in this lesson about why there is power in the blood of the Lamb. I'd like to make 3 points this morning. Number one, the blood of Jesus fulfilled the old covenant, and that's why it cleanses us from sin. Number two, the blood of Jesus gives us peace, right standing and favor with God, and we even become the children of God. And number three, the blood of the Lamb provides healing and protection and gives us the ability to overcome the devil. When Adam and Eve sinned, it produced guilt and shame in their lives, and they were separated from God and they ran and hid from God. And when God confronted them with their sin, their shame and guilt had caused them to produce a covering made out of fig leaves. But after the judgment was pronounced on them for their sin, God made a covering for their sin out of the skin of an animal. Now, the Bible doesn't say, but I've come to believe that that first sacrifice by God himself was a lamb, because that knowledge was passed on to Abel, their son, and then through Noah and down through the law of Moses. I believe that God made that lamb skin as a covering for their sin. God's law required a life for a life. Exodus 21 talks about an eye for an eye, a tooth for a tooth, and a life for a life. I believe the reason for that is found in Leviticus 17. It says, the life of this body is in the blood. And God said, I have given it to you upon the altar, for it is the blood that makes an atonement for the soul. In Leviticus 4, God said his plan is for people to bring a lamb as a sin offering. The New Testament amplifies that in Hebrews 9 and says, without the shedding of blood, there is no forgiveness of sin. However, Hebrews 9 says that it was not possible that the blood of an animal could remove their sin. That sin offering in the Old Testament was only a covering for their sin, a temporary covering to relieve them from the punishment and the condemnation of their sin. It could not remove their sin. But God's plan was that that lamb offering was to be symbolic of the Lamb of God who would take away the sins of the world. John the Baptist introduced Jesus that way, saying, behold, the Lamb of God who takes away the sins of the world. It says that he loved us and he washed us from our sins in his own blood. Jesus came to shed his blood for our sins. In Matthew 5, Jesus said, I did not come to destroy the law, I came to fulfill it. And the shedding of Jesus' blood was the fulfillment of that Old Testament blood sacrifice. Jesus was the Lamb of God who would shed his blood, not as a covering for our sin, but as a cleansing for our sin. Why is there such power in the blood of the Lamb? Because it was innocent blood. Because Jesus lived a life that was without sin, and so he was not under the curse of sin. And so he went to cross as the spotless Lamb of God. Hebrews 9 says that with his own blood, he entered once into that holy place, having obtained eternal redemption for us. In the Old Testament, the high priest would go once a year into that Holy of Holies, where the altar of God was, and he would sprinkle blood from the Lamb on the mercy seat of the Ark of the Covenant. And that blood would provide a covering for the sins of the people for 1 year. But it had to be renewed every year. But it says Jesus entered once and for all into that holy temple, a temple not made with hands, that holy place in heaven. And so after his death on the cross, after his resurrection, Jesus took his blood, ascended into heaven, and sprinkled his blood on the mercy seat in heaven as a continual reminder that the price for sin had been paid, and sins were no longer covered, the penalty was paid, and now the sins were forgiven. So the blood of Jesus is proof on the altar in heaven that the price is paid. It's like a shopping receipt. If I get stopped on my way out of Walmart They'll ask me, may I see your receipt? And I pull out my receipt, and this receipt is proof that the price is paid. It's proof that these things now belong to me. And the blood of Jesus is proof in heaven that our sins have been forgiven, that the price has been paid, and that we are now free from the guilt and the penalty of sin. And we should use this reminder, use this receipt. If Satan accuses you about your past sin, you can say, Satan, the price has been paid. The blood of Jesus is proof that the penalty has been paid. My sins are forgiven. Jesus said once in the gospel, Satan comes against me and he has nothing in me. And the same thing's true for you and I as the children of God. The penalty for our sins has been paid. And you need to use the blood of Jesus like your shopping receipt as proof to Satan, as proof to others, or even proof to your own self. The penalty has been paid. This receipt belongs to you. Use it. Use it in your own mind. Use it in your prayers to heaven. That's why I believe it's important for us to say every day, Lord, cleanse me of my sin. Lord, forgive me of my sin. Thank you for paying the price and the penalty for my sin. The blood of Jesus is proof, and it's a powerful thing that we must use in our lives. His blood is proof that the price has been paid in heaven. Number two, there's power in the blood of Jesus to give us peace with God. When Adam sinned, the curse was pronounced upon him and he was cast out of God's presence. His body was destined to die. It came from dust and it would return to dust. And his soul was in danger of hell. Leviticus said, the soul that sins will surely die. But Jesus Christ went to the cross as the Lamb of God, and he became a curse for us. He went to the cross as a spotless Lamb of God without sin, willing to pay the price, the penalty for our sin, so that we could have peace with God. Colossians 1, Paul said, Jesus made peace through the blood of his cross. To reconcile all things in the earth and in heaven unto himself. Jesus died to reconcile us back to God. 2 Peter chapter 1 says that after we have been cleansed by the blood of Jesus, we acquire the divine nature of God. This divine nature that we acquire is proof that we are the children of God. In the human body, proof of sonship is in the DNA. It's in the blood. And you and I have the divine nature, and that's proof that we are the children of the Most High God. His blood is powerful proof that we belong to the Most High God. It's like a birth certificate. It's like the proof from a DNA lab that the divine nature of God dwells on the inside of us. Beloved, now we are the children of God. We have pardon from sin because Jesus has paid the penalty. Hebrews 10:18 says, we have pardon of sin. Therefore, brethren, we now have confidence to enter into that holy place by the blood of Jesus. Adam was cast out of the garden. Fellowship with God was broken. But through Jesus Christ, we are restored. We are reconciled back to God as his children. And we can come with confidence to enter into that place because of the blood of Jesus. It's our divine invitation to enter into the presence of God. Like an event ticket here on the earth. When you walk into an event, they ask you to show your ticket, and that ticket grants you entrance into that event. You and I have the blood of Jesus as an event ticket that grants us access into the throne room of Almighty God, and we have confidence to enter into that holy place now. His blood is your ticket to heaven, to enter into God's presence. Use it. Use the blood of Jesus as a daily basis. Father, I come to you. I thank you for the cleansing of the blood of Jesus. I thank you that your divine nature has been planted in my heart. I thank you that because of his blood, I now have the right to enter into that place of fellowship and communion with you. The blood of Jesus is your ticket into that place of fellowship and communion with God. Use it. Number three, because of the blood of Jesus, we have a right to healing and protection. Acts 10:38 says this about Jesus. He went about doing good, healing all that were oppressed of the devil. This verse indicates to us that disease is an oppression of the devil. There was not sickness in the world before sin entered. There will not be sickness in heaven. It is a result of the curse of sin. And Jesus went about doing good, healing all, setting them free from the oppression of the devil. On the cross, Jesus not only bore the penalty for our sin, 1 Peter 2:24 says that Jesus bore our sins in his own body on the cross. And by his stripes, we were healed. By those bloody stripes that were placed on his back, they paid the price for our healing. It's like a prescription that you would get from the doctor. Your earthly doctor would write a prescription and say, you need to fulfill this and take this, and it will bring health and healing to your body. The blood of Jesus is like a prescription written by our Lord and Savior himself saying, this is your right to receive healing. This is the prescription from our great physician. Use it. Use it every day. Lord, I thank you. Not only do you forgive my sins because of the blood you shed on the cross, Lord, I thank you for health and healing. Even in the midst of this plague, Lord, I claim health from you in Jesus' name. Not because I've earned it, but because it's been prescribed by my Lord and Savior in heaven. Another part of this is that the blood of Jesus provides us with protection. It gives us authorization to have the protection of Almighty God. In Exodus 12, that original Passover, it says this, judgment is coming, but the blood shall be for you a token upon your house. And when I see the blood, I will pass over you, and the plague shall not be upon you to destroy you. They were to sacrifice a lamb, take the blood from that lamb, and put it on the doorpost of their house. And it was their faith in that blood of an earthly lamb that brought protection to the father in his obedience, to the wife in her obedience, and to the children in that family. He said, when I see the blood on your doorpost, judgment will pass over you. The same thing is true for us individually. If we apply the blood of Christ to our hearts and our lives, the judgment of sin will pass over us. If faith in the blood of an earthly lamb could bring protection to a man and his family, how much more will the faith in the blood of the Lamb of God protect you and your family? God has said, when I see the blood, I will pass over you. So be sure and take the blood and apply it to your life every day. In the morning, Father, cleanse me by your blood. Lord, may your blood keep me protected from the attacks of the enemy. May no plague come nigh my dwelling. Read Psalms 91. It says he will give his angels charge. He will authorize his angels to protect you and to hold you up in their hands, lest you might stumble. Psalm 34, it said, the angels of the Lord surround those who reverence the Lord, and he will deliver them. Just like an earthly order for protection that you might get from a police department, they order a protection around you, around your house, around your family. The blood of Jesus is a heavenly order for divine protection from the angels of Almighty God. Heaven's warriors are authorized to give you divine protection. Use it, claim it every day. You can rest on the promise of protection from the blood of Jesus Christ. It cleanses you from sin. The blood of Jesus gives us peace with God so that we can become the children of God. And number three, the blood of Jesus paid the price for our healing. And the blood of Jesus gives us divine protection from the attacks of the enemy. One of my favorite scriptures is from Revelation 12:11. It says, they overcame him by the blood of the Lamb and the word in their testimony. You and I have not only been cleansed by the blood of Jesus, we've been born into the family of God, and we have his DNA, his divine nature on the inside of us, and we can claim his healing and his protection, and we can overcome the devil by the blood of the Lamb and the word in our testimony. I believe that we can be applying the blood of Jesus every morning, every noon, every night. Claim that as a continual provision that's been given to us by our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. There's amazing power in the blood of the Lamb. Use it every day. Claim it in your prayers. It's not just for cleansing. It's for the divine nature. It's for the healing, and it's for the protection of the children of Almighty God. I pray you'll be encouraged to not only receive this lesson, but to put it into application in your life every day. Let's pray. Heavenly Father, I thank you for this lesson about the awesome privilege we have to not only be forgiven of sin, cleansed of sin, but to become the children of the Most High God, knowing that the divine blood of Jesus causes his divine nature, his DNA, to live and to dwell on the inside of us. And because of that, there's a protection order. There's a prescription for our healing. There's an authorization to the angels of Almighty God to protect us and to keep us safe. Lord, I pray you keep your people safe in the midst of this coronavirus. I pray you keep us safe from the sin and corruption that's in the world. Lord, help us to live holy lives that are pleasing to you. Lord, prepare us to come and to live and dwell with you forever. I thank you for the power and the blood of Jesus. We receive it and we apply it to our lives this day. In his holy name we pray. Amen. God bless you. Thank you for joining us today. There is power in the blood of the Lamb.
There is power, power, wonder-working power in the blood.